Welcome to ECE 6340 at the University of Utah. In lecture number 6, we're going to look at successive overrelaxation. SOR is an iterative method of solving matrix equations. It still allows us to solve AX equal B. We're looking for the vector of variables X, and we're going to solve that iteratively. I've just redrawn the matrix here to remind you how the nomenclature works. If we were doing back substitution, we would have had zeros on all of our lower elements, all the elements below the diagonal, and then this is the algorithm we could have used. We could have said that xi, we would have begun with our last one, was minus the diagonal or the element times xj plus bi divided by the diagonal element. We would have started at the bottom and worked up progressively. Well, that is a form of iteration, and in fact, we could use this to develop an iterative method. Imagine what we could do if we did not have a upper diagonal matrix, and if we had not, in fact, yet discovered the values of x's. We could guess them. So, if we simply guessed, then we could come up with a method that is called Jacobi's method. And what Jacobi's method says is, let me just guess my values of x's. I'm going to call them x of k's. And then I'm going to find the x of k plus 1's by using my previous values of x sub k. And then I'm just going to keep iterating with this method until I get closer and closer and closer to my x values. This method does in fact work, but there are several that are more efficient. So let's go to our next one. Gauss-Seidel is an adaptation of Jacobi's method, where instead of only using the old values of x, when you have the new values, it uses the new values instead. No major change, just be sure that you're always using your new values. Successive overrelaxation is based on the Gauss-Seidel method, which is based on the Jacobi's method, which is based on the back substitution. This method moves toward relaxation or towards the solution of your problem faster. This is a relaxation method. You can see that we're trying to find our new values of x based on our old values of x and something called the residual. In fact, we could say that this is the residual at the kth value. This right here is a relaxation factor, which is a multiple where we multiply our error or our residual in order to move faster towards convergence. To move from Gauss-Seidel to successive overrelaxation, what I'm going to do right here is add one more value of the iteration. So this is going to go from I to n instead of I plus 1 to n, and then let's just add it back in here because I've subtracted off one more value. Let's add one more back in. So this is going to be j from I to I of aii x sub I. Notice that's divided by aii, so what I have here is x sub I of k plus 1 equals minus sum from j equals 1 to I minus 1 aij xj of k plus 1 minus the sum from j equals I to the n aij xj of k plus b of I, and I'm going to bring this value out here to the front. And that's going to be x sub I of k, and then I'm going to divide all of these by aii. So this is set up in such a way that I can define a residual. This right here is going to be my residual value, and then all I'm going to do is multiply that by omega in order to define the successive overrelaxation method. Now, one of the big questions is how to define omega in order to get good relaxation. We can see that for omega equals 1, this method reduces to the Gauss-Seidel method. The method converges for 0, for omega between 0 and 2. If omega is less than 0 or equal to 0, or omega is 2 or greater, it does not converge. This method converges for a positive definite matrix. That means that when the matrix is reduced to diagonal elements only, all the elements are positive. If you have omega between 0 and 1, the convergence is slower than Gauss-Seidel, which you generally would not want, and if you have omega between 1 and 2, the convergence is faster than Gauss-Seidel. Optimal omega is based on the spectral radius, but we can approximate it using the method shown here.